What a confidence booster. Look at that highlight. Fling, fling, fling. Aibo, aibo.
We are going to be moving a step further to show you how to properly light your green screen using Adobe After Effects as the compositing software. Hey everyone, my name is Joshua Mian and I am the director and visual effect artist for Filmic Star Production. Today, I want to appreciate everyone that checked out my previous video, the VFX breakdown for the movie The Blaqie by Jarvis and Asio Entertainment. Reading your comments gave me chills from the visual concept and compositing questions you all asked in the video. If you have not followed this channel, please do follow this channel. We are the creators of the Nigeria Flash, Akinduwa Flash, Rise of Zeros, Den of African Jungle, and other creative content. So today with me on the studio is our model for the day. Her name is Easy, and she's going to be the one modeling for this background change. Before we jump right into this tutorial, I want to give us tips that is going to help us in this green screen effect. First thing for you to note is this. You have to properly light your green screen using three basic lighting. We have the key light, we have the fill light, and we have the background light or overhead light, so that you can be able to achieve a clean key. And the second advice is you have to place your subject far away from the green screen in order to avoid spill. If you don't want to place your subject far away from the green screen, you have to create a light that has to separate the subject from the background, so that when you key, you just have a perfect cue.
What a confidence booster.
Talking about light, camera, studio setup, and makeup artist, this video was powered by SINTOGLAM, an academy focused on makeup artistry.
Look at that highlight.
Unleash your inner glow with SINTOGLAM, personalized makeup for bridal, editorial, and special events. Book your radiant transformation today with SINTOGLAM and let your beauty shine. So follow SINTOGLAM on Instagram and on TikTok. All the equipment for this tutorial was provided by SINTOGLAM. Let's jump right into this tutorial. Load any version of Adobe After Effects installed on your PC or Mac. No third-party plugin is needed for this video. Click on New Project, and this is the interface. The project panel and the effect control is what we need. Now on this project panel, right click to import your video file, go to import and click on file. Go to where your files are kept and select it. To create a new composition, you can click and drag your video footage to this tab here, create new composition, and your composition is created. There's another way to create composition, I won't do that. Just right click on the video file itself and create new composition. Composition is another name for sequence timeline. I am going to trim out the section I want to make use of from this video. I can come to this point, click drag to trim, do the same for the end part, but I'm going to undo that and make use of this shortcut key. To trim the start point, I'm going to press B on my keyboard, and to trim the end point, N on the keyboard. Right click on this tab and select trim come to work area. Now that our video and composition is set, the next step is to apply the key light effect to enable us to remove the background from this footage. This is the best time to rename your clip. I'm going to name this clip Easy Footage. Select your clip you want to apply this key light effect to. Move up to the effect panel, select key, and on this tab you can find various effects for removing background and correcting it in case of error. Select the key light effect and the effect is applied to our footage. Another cool way to add effect is the effect tab right here, where you can easily type in and search the effect you want. Click drag and drop and the effect is applied to your video footage. And if you can't find this tab right here, move up to Windows, search for effect and preset, click to bring up this tab. Now we have two keylight effects applied to this clip, so I'll proceed and delete one. Take note of this first session, view. It is set to final result, and that's how the final image is going to look. Click this tab and take note of screen mount. That's what we are going to use to monitor if we have a perfect background key. Screen color is where you select the color of the background you want to remove. You can click on this color box and randomly select your background color. But this might not give you the best key result. As you can see, the color in the box is lemon, and that might affect your image in some case. Ctrl Z to undo. Use the color picker and select the darkest part or the brightest part of your green screen. The background is completely out with just one tap and no adjustment. Observe the background to see that we have a perfect key. Now we don't have the effect advanced speed suppressor or key cleaner. I'll bring the footage from the VFX breakdown and apply the same effect so we can do the side-by-side comparison. Now you can see the two footage on your screen. This is due to the light effect on the green screen. You can light your green screen basically by visualizing the background you want to add to your image to know if it's going to be a bright background or a dark background. If it's going to be a dark background you want to add, your light should be on the green screen and not on your subject. And if you are going to have a bright background or a lighter background, so definitely the light should be on your subject and on this green screen. Take note, the light can also be on your subject and not be on the green screen because light is going to be scattered around the green screen and it's going to help you.
What a confidence booster.
The distance of your subject from the green screen, that is what is going to help you. And the required distance is 4 to 7 feet so that when you tap your color picker and you select your green screen, you don't have any spill. With just one light, you can be able to kill out your background because of what the camera settings. Aperture 4.8, shutter speed we are going for 1/1300, and for the ISO we are not exceeding 400. These settings is going to help you get a perfect key. So with just one light you can be able to get a realistic effect. Don't forget, the background you're going to add controls the way you are going to light up your green screen. For more observations, switch to screen matte. The area you don't want should be completely black and the subject completely white. Switch back to final result and I am going to turn off the background to enable transparent view. I am going to leave the screen gain and the screen balance on default, but you can adjust if you are having issues with your key. The speed bias and alpha bias also serve as speed suppressor. This is a green screen. I will make use of the blue color to suppress the spill. Screen pre-blur helps to blur the edges of the subject. Set that to 1. Under screen mount, this is where we set for the clip black and the clip white. We are going to adjust the clip white to make sure that we don't have any transparency, and we are going to increase the clip black to ensure that the part we want to remove from this green screen is completely out. I don't need to adjust my clip black and clip white settings because my key is perfect. But for the sake of this tutorial, let's say for example we are having issues with this key. Just like this, it is where clip black and clip white comes in. Increase clip black till the background is completely black and decrease clip white till your object is completely white in order to avoid transparency. I hope that was helpful. Shrink and glow, I will give that a negative value, but you don't want to exceed -2 because you start losing details. 1.4 is okay for this clip. Set the screen softness to 2, darken this color a bit and set to add color.
What a confidence booster. Look at that highlight.
I will decrease my clip white value just to avoid any form of transparency.
The next effect we want to add is curves, but if we don't have a perfect key, after key light, we have the advanced speed suppressor, key cleaner, then before we add our curves.
Go to your effects tab, color correction and select the curves effect, which can be used for color balance. The upper part of the curves controls the brightness, the lower part controls the contrast. I will do a quick adjustment between the RGB channel to balance the image. Lastly, let's add the advanced speed suppressor even though we have a clean key. Go to your effects tab, key, select the advanced speed suppressor. Change the method from standard to ultra. Key color green because we use a green screen. If you are using a blue screen, key color will be blue.
Spill range 69. Click and drag it above the curves effect.
For this particular video, we don't need the key cleaner, but for the previous video we did for the VFX breakdown, we used the key cleaner. One major thing to take note of is masking. We don't need to do that extra masking or rotoscoping because the green screen is set up properly.
Let's add a background. If you use 3D software like Cinema 4D and the rest, you can import your 3D file into After Effects. For this tutorial, I'll be using a random 2D picture. Put the image layer below your footage and rename to background. To increase the size, hit S on the keyboard to bring up the scale option. I will increase the value to scale up the image to fit the screen. Press P on the keyboard to bring up the position settings. The first value is the X axis for the left and right, and the second value is the Y axis for up and down. After adjusting our background to fit, it is time to add our camera lens blur effect.
In case you have multiple backgrounds that you blended together to create a scene, you create an adjustment layer.
You can choose to add this effect directly to the background layer, but I want to create an adjustment layer. Go to Layer, New, Adjustment Layer. Place the layer in between the main footage and the background layer. Go to Effects tab, Blur and Sharpen, select Camera Lens Blur. Set the blur radius to 17. For the shape, select Octagon. You can flex around the different value and see what works best for you. I forgot to save this project in the beginning of this tutorial. Now is the best time to save. For me, I guess I am lucky my After Effects hardly crashed. Now that we have our project saved, quickly, let's move to the video export settings. If you are not using Dynamic Link with Premiere Pro, Ctrl M on your keyboard to bring up the render queue panel. Output model, click lossless and change it to QuickTime. If you want your system to last long, you can check this box if you want to resize your footage, but I'm okay with my 4K footage. Click OK. Output to select the export destination and make sure you give it a name. Click save and proceed to click render. Give it time and your video will be ready.
Somebody asked a question on how I was able to composite the video to blend with the background. First thing, we have to observe where all the light source are coming from. Either we are adjusting the video to meet the background or we are just blending the two to match each other. Next effect we're going to be adding is the hue and saturation for color balance and manipulation. I will apply this effect to the background layer. Use saturation to boost the color or reduce it. The master hue can be used to change color range. This slider here is to increase or decrease the brightness. You can also add the hue and saturation to your main footage layer for further adjustment.
So what I'll do basically here is observe the colors for my videos and I will observe the colors for my background and I will start adjusting.
That's all for this section. Don't forget to add your color blending, and to blend your color, we have Lumetric in Adobe After Effects to color grade RGB curves, hue and saturation to be able to blend your colors.
Now, I will show you how you can create and animate this background using a solid layer. Select your adjustment layer and your background layer and press delete. Go to layer, new, solid. You can see the color for the solid is orange. We want to stick to the orange. Now go to your effects tab, go to generate and click gradient ramp. If you are interested for this tutorial, drop it on the comment section below and I will pause the entire process for the video.
After watching this video, share your thoughts on the comment section below. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and share if the video was helpful to you. And don't forget to check out other of our video short films like The Rise of Zeros, Nigeria Flash, Akinzua Flash, The Likes of Den of Africa Jungle. For those of you that are unable to do certain effects, I know what to do. I'll call Adobe and you can drop your request in the comment section below. Then I will make your request known to Adobe and tell them what you want them to adjust in this compositing software, which is After Effects. I am your host, Umia. See you next time.